Welcome to the third lesson in learning Zapier in 14 days. We just saw how Zoe set up online orders and catering requests using Zapier interfaces, tables, and automating things with Zaps. Now Zoe is starting to get a bunch of questions. What are the ingredients? What are your hours? Do you offer catering? These questions can be distracting when Zoe needs to focus on making that taco and serving the customers at the taco truck. So she's gonna create a chatbot using Zapier that's going to help based on FAQs that she already has and knowledge that she has stored in Zapier. This chatbot's gonna allow her to focus on the most important things. So let's see just how easy it was for Zoe to set something like this up. When you create a chatbot in Zapier, there's a few things you get to adjust. The first and arguably the most important thing is the directive. This is where you're gonna tell the chatbot exactly how to behave, how to respond to users and customers asking it questions. Once she's done that and saved the changes, she can always test it out right here within chatbots and maybe ask a few questions. There are two other things that are gonna make this chatbot smarter. We're gonna add some knowledge sources. The first one is an FAQ that she already has. She's gonna bring that in through a text-based file that she has saved on her computer. It'll upload into the chatbot, and then Zoe can just click add source. Now the chatbot's gonna be armed with those FAQs. So you can see what that file looks like. Here it is, text-based file with all the information her customers might need. Zoe's gonna edit this style, add a favicon, an avatar. Now this chatbot's gonna do more than just answer questions. There's some logic you can add into it. Zoe's added some suggested questions they can ask. The user can just click those to ask the questions. And when they do that, the chatbot responds from that knowledge source that we uploaded. Now, if someone does need help and wants to talk to a person, we wanna make sure that they're able to do that. We're gonna add some logic here to collect the name and email, and we can choose to collect this when someone says, talk to someone. This information will be stored in a Zapier table, and then we'll set up a Zap so that Zoe gets notified anytime someone needs help. So I'll say, I need to talk to someone. When I say that, it'll ask for my name and my email. Back over in the table, we can see that that comes in. Now, every time that comes in, Zoe needs to know about it. So we'll click automate your data, and we're gonna create a Zap that runs anytime a record is created in this table. Here we are back in that Zap editor again. We're gonna look at the trigger, we're gonna test it, get that example that came in, and send an email. We configure this just like we did all the other Zaps, sending it to Zoe, and mapping in information that would be helpful for Zoe in the email, like the name and the email address of the person reaching out. So now Zoe has an automated chatbot in Zapier that leverages AI to answer customer questions about ingredients, and if they ever need help, the customer's info is stored in Zapier tables and Zoe gets an email notification. With this system working behind the scenes, Zoe's able to focus on what matters most. And in the next lesson, we're gonna look at how Zoe manages reviews and uses AI to draft up a reply. So I will see you in the next video.